This is The Jabberwocky by Lewis Carroll. 'Twas brisalic in the slithy toads, degiring gimble in the wave. All mimsy were the borogoves and the mome raths outgrabe. Beware the Jabberwock, my son, the jaws that bite, the claws that catch. Beware the Jubjub bird, and shun the frumious Bandersnatch. He took his vorpal sword in hand, long time the manxome foe he sought. So rested he by the tum-tum tree, and stood a while in thought. And as in oofish thought he stood, the Jabberwock with eyes aflame came whistling through the tulgey wood, and burbled as it came. One, two, and through the vorpal blade went snicker-snack. He left it dead, and with his head he went galumphing back. And hast thou slain the Jabberwock? Come to my arms, my beamish boy. O fragilous day, calloo, callay, he chortled in his joy. 'Twas brillig in the slithy toads, degiring gimble in the wave. All mimsy were the borogoves, and the mome raths outgrabe. This happens to be one of my all-time favorite poems. I remember my mom reading to me in a poetry book when I was younger, and I always sort of loved the images in them, in the poem, because it's totally nonsensical and everyone's interpretation is different, but you can still get the same impact given the grammar and the structure. And that's what I focus on when I teach this poem, that's what I focus on when I read this poem. And at its root, it's an adventure story. It's a kid going off, defeating this Jabberwocky, and coming home successful. I've always enjoyed that. If we take the verse, he took his vorpal sword in hand. Well, we have no idea what vorpal means, but we can understand taking a sword in hand. One, through, the vorpal blade went snicker-snack. He left it dead, and with his head, he went galumphing back.
It seems very pretty, but it's rather hard to understand. Somehow, it seems to fill my head with ideas, only I don't exactly know what they are. However, somebody killed something. That's clear at any rate. You seem very clever at explaining words, sir. Would you kindly tell me the meaning of the poem called Jabberwocky?
Let's hear it. I can explain all the poems that ever were invented, and a good many that haven't been invented just yet.
'Twas brillig and the slithy toes, the gyre and gimble in the wave. All mimsy were the borogoves, and the mome raths outgrabe.
That's enough to begin with. There are plenty of hard words there. Brillig means 4 o'clock in the afternoon, the time when you begin broiling things for dinner.
That'll do very well. And slithy?
Well, slithy means lithe and slimy. Lithe is the same as active. You see, it's like a portmanteau. There are two meanings packed up into one word.
I see it now. And what are toves?
Well, toves are something like badgers. They're something like lizards. And they're something like corkscrews.
They must be very curious looking creatures.
They are that. Also, they make their nests under sundials. Also, they live on cheese.
And what's to gyre and gimble?
To gyre is to go round and round like a gyroscope, and to gimble is to make holes like a gimblet.
And the wave is the grass plot around the sundial, I suppose?
Of course it is. It's called a wave, you know, because it goes a long way before it, and a long way behind it.
And a long way beyond each side.
Exactly so. Well then, mimsy is flimsy and miserable. There's another portmanteau for you. And borogove is a thin, shabby-looking bird with its feathers sticking out all around. Something like a live mop.
And then mome raths? I'm afraid I'm giving you a great deal of trouble.
Well, a rath is a sort of green pig, but mome, I'm not certain about that. I think it's short for from home, meaning that they lost their way, you know.
And what does outgrabe mean?
Well, outgribbing is something between bellowing and whistling, with a kind of sneeze in the middle. However, you'll hear it done, maybe, down in the wood yonder, and when you've once heard it, you'll be quite content. Who's been repeating all that hard stuff to you?
I read it in a book.